social distance between you and other travel parties, and to wash your hands often. We encourage all our guests to follow CDC guidelines and to wear face coverings while indoors.
Here, hold that. It's taping right now.
Okay.
I have a feeling we're going to get crowded. Better be safe than sorry.
Absolutely. Mine's on my wrist and will only take a half a second to put it on. You know?
Yep.
It was death, and he felt cheated because travelers usually drown in the
river. But death was coming. He pretended to congratulate the three brothers upon their magic, and so that each had earned a prize for having been clever enough to evade him.
The eldest brother, who was a combative man, asked for a wand more powerful than any in existence. A wand that must always win duels for its owner. So they fashioned him one from an elder tree that grew nearby.
Then the second brother, who was an arrogant man, decided he wanted to humiliate Death still further, and asked for the power to recall others from death. So Death picked up a stone from the riverbank and gave it to him.
Finally, Death turned to the third brother, a humble and wise man. He did not trust Death, so he asked for something that would enable him to go forth from that place without being followed by Death. And Death, most unwillingly, handed over his own cloak. In due course, the brothers separated, each for his own destination.
The first brother travelled to a distant village, where he sought out a wizard with whom he had once quarreled. Naturally, with the elder wand as his weapon, he could not fail to win the duel that followed. Leaving his enemy upon the floor, the eldest brother proceeded to an inn, where he boasted loudly of the powerful bond he had snatched from Death himself, and of how it made him invincible. But that very night, while it was impact upon the oldest brother as he lay upon his bed, whereupon he stole the wand, and with it the brother's life.
So Death took the first one for his own.
Meanwhile, the second brother took the stone that had the power to recall the dead, and turned it thrice in hand. To his amazement and his delight, the figure of a girl he had once hoped to marry, before her untimely death, appeared once before him. Yet soon she turned sad and cold, for she did not belong in the mortal world. The riven man was on the throne, and the second brother took his own life. So the strength joined her.
And so Death took the second brother for his own. As for the third brother, Death searched for many years. But he was never able to find him. It was only when he had attained a great age that the youngest brother shed the cloak of invisibility and gave it to his son. Tales of courage,
gallantry,
friendship,